and the Gang and Joanna. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 9 o'clock on Sunday the 25th of September. Good morning, this is Justine Green. Labour is setting out how it would turn the UK into a green superpower as a way to deliver growth. A British man has described how he thought he was going to die while being held captive by Russian-backed forces in Ukraine. And Italians are going to the polls in an election which could lead to their most right-wing government since the Second World War. The Labour leader, Sir Keir Starmer, will use the first full day of his party's annual conference in Liverpool to set out his plans to secure economic growth with a huge investment in green energy. He's expected to say that his measures would cut energy bills, help tackle the climate crisis and create hundreds of thousands of jobs. Writing in the Mail on Sunday, the Prime Minister Liz Truss insists her government's tax cuts will usher in a decade of dynamism and help people thrive. Our political correspondent Damian Grammaticus is in Liverpool.
Labour say there should be a sort of more focus on, in an energy crisis, energy measures that would sort of future-proof the economy. So growing renewables, insulating homes, that sort of thing, that the focus should be there rather than subsidising or using as the situation at the minute, which will be what they say the oil and gas companies continuing to make big profits. So Labour pushing on that sort of thing and thinking that that budget gives them an opportunity.
The new Transport Secretary, Anne-Marie Trevelyan, has held talks with rail unions aimed at resolving the long-running dispute over pay and conditions behind a series of strikes across the network. The head of the RMT described the meeting as a good start after Ms. Trevelyan's predecessor, Grant Shapps, refused to meet union leaders. More strike action is planned from next Saturday, the day before the Conservative Party conference starts in Birmingham. Italians are going to the polls today in an election that's widely expected to lead to a victory for the hard right. The frontrunner, Giorgia Meloni, leads the Brothers of Italy party, which has its roots in the neo-fascist movement. She's hoping to become the country's first female prime minister. Our Europe editor, Katia Adler, is in Rome.
Up until Russia's invasion of Ukraine, Italy was hugely reliant on Moscow for gas supplies. It's been particularly hard hit by spiralling energy costs, and Italian businesses were already struggling after the COVID-19 pandemic. So while Brussels and NATO allies worry about Giorgia Meloni's far-right background, voters here are more focused on economic issues. Giorgia Meloni benefits from staying on the opposition benches over the last years, unlike all the other main Italian parties. So she hasn't been tainted by making unpopular choices.
A British man, freed after being held by Russian-backed forces in Ukraine, says he was treated worse than a dog and thought he was going to be killed. Aidan Aslin was captured in April while fighting in the southeastern city of Mariupol. He was one of five Britons released as part of a prisoner exchange between Russia and Ukraine. Speaking to The Sun on Sunday, Mr. Aslin said an interrogation by one Russian officer in Donetsk almost cost him his life.
And he was like, do you know who I am? And I was like, no. And he says, like, I'm your death, basically, in Russian. I saw myself, I'd been stabbed. So I knew there's a very high possibility that I'm about to be killed.
Canada is sending its military to Nova Scotia after Tropical Storm Fiona battered the coastline. Hundreds of thousands of people across five provinces have been left without power, and officials have warned of severe damage. The Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau, described the situation as critical.
As we see the images of houses falling into the sea, of waves destroying property and buildings, our first thought needs to be for people, to make sure that people are staying safe.
People living in coastal areas of the Philippines are being told to leave their homes before the arrival of a super typhoon. Noru is due to hit later and currently has sustained wind speeds of more than 110 miles an hour. Hundreds of sheep will be driven across London Bridge this morning in a tradition that dates back to medieval times when farmers would take their livestock into the city to market. The practice died out last century but was revived in 2013 by the Worshipful Company of Woolmen. They wanted to celebrate their ancient right to bring animals across the Thames toll-free. And today's weather, it will be cool and bright for most. The cloud will thicken across northwestern areas through the day, and there could be some patchy drizzle in places. Heavy rain will move into northern Scotland in late afternoon and into this evening. And top temperatures today will reach 18 Celsius in London, 16 in Cardiff and 15 in Edinburgh and Belfast. That's the BBC News. It's 9:05.
Thank you very much. Stand by for love songs. Good morning. This is Steve with the team. How you doing?
Steve writes Sunday love songs. BBC Radio 2.
Well, I think we can start. Go ahead.